Welcome back, guys. In this new video, we're going to take a look at the energy flow to or from a system. Now, we say that the first law of thermodynamics states that energy can't be created nor destroyed. All that happens is it changes forms. What this really means is anytime we have a balanced chemical reaction, remember, we say that the number of atoms and the types of atoms have to be the same on both sides. So if I start out with 10 hydrogens on as reactants, I have to end with 10 hydrogens as products. That's what the first law of thermodynamics really is saying. Now we're going to say we've discussed systems versus surroundings. These are the two types of concepts we're dealing with when it comes to energy changes. We're going to say that the system either gains or loses energy based on the surroundings. But now we're going to pay more attention to the surroundings. We're going to say we are normally concerned with just the surroundings, and we're going to use this equation here. Delta E equals Q plus W. We're going to say that delta E represents the internal energy of our system. And we're going to say when it comes to the variable Q, Q also equals delta H. Delta H is enthalpy. When we talk about enthalpy, enthalpy just means that our reaction either absorbs or releases heat or energy in order for the reaction to occur. That's all enthalpy is concerned with. We're also going to say that W equals negative pressure times the change in volume. Pressure here will be in atmospheres, and this delta V means change in volume. So that means final volume minus initial volume. And the volume here is usually in liters.